everybody, I'm Tiffany Grant, the American anime voice actor, and you might know me from projects like Nojiko in One Piece or Laura Bodovic in Infinite Stratos, but you probably know me as Asuka from Neon Genesis Evangelion.
What are you, stupid?
Working on an anime, it's really different because you go into the studio and you see the script for the very first time right there. So it's really good to have a lot of input from the director to inform the actors about what's going on in the show, who are these characters, when is this set, is it set in the future, is it in Japan, is it in outer space, is it a fantasy, is it a school comedy, whatever. So I take all of that information and of course watch some of the scenes, see what my character is like. Really a lot of the decisions about how that character is going to be played, that actually takes place before that. Because, of course, there's an audition a lot of times. And so based on what I've done with the audition, that also guides us into what that character is going to sound like. When we're recording in the studio, we do actually watch it in Japanese, the bit that we're about to record, before I do it in English. So I have that input. I can hear their inflection and the feeling they've put into it. And of course, I'm watching the video. And I've got the script in front of me, so I know what's going on. I would say that there is some influence from the original performance, but of course, we are doing this for an English-speaking audience, so we want to make it accessible to them. So it's kind of a melding of those things. When a dub is created, there's only one actor. So the voice actor is alone there in that recording booth, and then you typically will just have your director and a sound engineer. Very often, those are all of the people who are present. So it's not uncommon for us not to meet the other actors who are working in a scene actually with us at the same time. Kind of takes a little bit of getting used to, but obviously it's quite different than working on a play or an ordinary film. The thing that people most know me for, especially in Australia, is playing Asuka from Evangelion, and it's a character that I've been playing now for a pretty long time, I think about 17 years. And I really have taken her under my wing. I think of her as my little kind of bratty kid sister in a way. But I have a lot of feeling for her, so I get quite defensive when people attack Asuka if they have negative things to say about her. I mean, she's been through a lot, and she's 14 years old and defending the world. I think she's very spunky, and I admire her that she says whatever she thinks. She's going to let you know what she's thinking. And I've always said that Asuka is really, I think, the way a lot of us wish that we were. Like, really, I wish I could be so much more open and honest with people like Asuka and just tell them what I'm thinking. But we really just go, no, it's okay. Asuka would never say that.
Just say how you feel, damn it!
I don't know.
I know it's a little bit odd, but he was a very, very famous American actor and entertainer called Bob Hope. And he was quite well known throughout the world, actually, for many, many decades. And I was so inspired by the fact that he was very successful in a lot of different ventures. He starred on Broadway, he worked in vaudeville, he worked in radio, he worked in film. Most comedians, even today, will still acknowledge that he had maybe some of the best comedic timing ever in film or just in entertainment in general. And really, timing for recording, dubbing an anime, it's a very important thing. So I like to think maybe I learned a little bit from watching all those Bob Hope films. It's not really an apples to apples comparison if you're trying to compare like a Japanese performance and an English performance. I mean, it would be like, comparing productions of Shakespeare. People have done millions of productions of Shakespeare over the years in various different settings and in different languages, and it's perfectly acceptable. As a matter of fact, the great director, Shinichi Watanabe, Nabashin, made the comment before that he's pleased for people to watch his show in any language as long as it comes across well and they're laughing in the right places. He doesn't mind whether you're watching it in Japanese or English or, I don't know, Swahili, whatever. Usually what I say is start wherever you are. I think that that's really the best advice. It is voice acting, So I think really acting is the most important component to that. So I would say get involved with projects in your community, whether that's like doing some kind of a community theater, amateur film, independent filmmaking. Meet up with people who have your same interests and get to work on projects, because if you don't start, if you don't get into it, if you don't just get out there and do it, then it's not going to happen for you. So follow your passions and just make it a reality for yourself. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Madman's Anime Snack Time, and don't forget to subscribe to Madman's YouTube channel. What? You haven't subscribed yet? What are you, stupid?